It's a large number of policemen, some forming chains, waiting for hours today at a police station in Chandigarh before Vikas Barala, the son of the Haryana BJP chief Subhash Barala, arrived for his questioning over charges that he stalked a woman and chased her on the streets of Chandigarh last week. When it started pouring, the police and media team stayed put. Vikas Barala, 23 years of age, finally drove in nearly 3 hours after his 11 a.m. deadline to appear. The moment we learnt about the notice, Vikas headed for Chandigarh. He will cooperate fully with the police, said Mr. Barala, that's Vikas's father, to reporters, even pausing to take a call from his son during the press conference. Vikas and his friend Ashish are out on bail after they were arrested by a police patrol team on Saturday following their chilling high-speed chase that the police say has been recorded on at least 6 CCTV cameras. But has he been arrested? That's the big question. We will try and answer that with Nikhil Pandey. But first, the reactions.
Nahi amne. किसी भी तरह की इस मामले में राजनीति की है, ना ही जांच को भटकाने का कोई प्रयास किया है। जो भी पुलिस इसमें जांच के अंदर जिस प्रकार के भी आरोप उसके ऊपर लगेंगे, उस आरोप के ऊपर कार्रवाई हो। अगर इस केस में मेरे खुद के बेटे का जिस प्रकार से नाम आया है और वो तफ्तीश में शामिल है, अगर कहीं कोई पुलिस की जांच या उस बेटी के बयान के आधार पर कोई कार्रवाई होती है तो कानून उसके ऊपर डट करके कार्रवाई करे।
हमने ये माना है कि वर्णिका कुंडू को न्याय मिलना चाहिए। जो भी शिकायत करता है, हमारा कहना यह है कि हमारी सबसे पहले संतुष्टि शिकायतकर्ता की संतुष्टि है। असंतुष्ट वो लोग हैं जो वर्णिका कुंडू के शब्दों का सम्मान नहीं करना चाहते, जो इसको अपना एक राजनीतिक हथियार बनाना चाहते हैं, जो उस बच्ची के साथ जो भी हुआ है वो अपना कोर्ट में पक्ष रखेगी, जिनके प्रति शिकायत है वो अपना कोर्ट में पक्ष रखेंगे, परंतु वास्तव में अगर वर्णिका कुंडू की भावनाओं के साथ कोई खिलवाड़ कर रहा है तो वो कांग्रेस कर रही है और INLD कर रही है।
All right, let's just give you the background of all that's happened in this case. It's a very clear a girl. Her name is Varnika Kundu, a 29-year-old DJ. She alleged that Vikas and Ashish, Vikas of course being the son of Haryana BJP chief Subhash Barala, they blocked her way, they banged on her car window and tried to force her door open as they stalked her around midnight in Chandigarh a few days back. In a Facebook post that went viral is where she made these claims. She also, of course, went to the police and complained and filed an FIR. And she said that she was lucky because I'm not lying, raped and murdered in a ditch somewhere. What is it that we know at this point in time in terms of the facts? The facts state, according to two CCTV camera, footage from those two CCTV cameras that has been released, we understand and can see categorically that a white SUV was chasing a black car. And this has also been confirmed by the police that say that we have the evidence through these CCTV cameras that reflect that, yes, this chase just happened. So there was that harassment that happened. There was that stalking at least that happened. Now, is there CCTV footage that has emerged that reflects very categorically that doors were banged and they tried to open the door of the car? That is not the case right now. But what are the questions that are being asked of the police right now? They say that they've got footage from 6 CCTV cameras. But there is an understanding, there are also reports that a total of 8 CCTV cameras were on this particular route when the girl was chased. So what of the other 2 CCTV cameras? What of that footage? The other question that's very pertinent is that the police say that these two, they refuse to actually undergo a blood and a urine sample test at the time of their arrest, not arrest, but when they were actually first brought in by the police and the charges were laid on them on that same night. At this point in time, that could also result in grounds for not giving them bail. So that is really the understanding. So will they be taken into custody or will they be arrested? That's the question that needs to be answered. Nikhil Pandey with us on the story, joining us right now. Nikhil, I can understand that there is complete chaos out there. But tell us, have you been able to confirm so far that they have actually been arrested?
Well, Amitoj, what we can confirm to you right now, and it's raining very heavily in Chandigarh. We're actually at the Sector 26 police station. You can see visuals behind us. The two, Vikas Barala and Ashish, came in. They were whisked away by the cops. You can see them standing behind us in a line. There was a veritable fortress of police deployment here. There was great anticipation, not just in the media, but also on the cops, that they would arrive. His father, Subhash Barala, holding a press conference just minutes before they came in. They came in and they were whisked away by the cops. The buzz is, of course, that now the next big development could be whether the kidnapping charge will be added, but unless, of course, the police doesn't confirm it to us, we will not be able to confirm it ourselves. But that is the important aspect. What happens now? Now that he has, along with Ashish, finally come to the police station, in spite of the fact that the summons was at 11 a.m., what happens now? Will that crucial charge be added? And as you pointed out, the DGP also saying to us in the morning that the blood and the urine samples, which also form crucial parts of the investigation, also not being recorded, the men refusing to record those samples. So that also raises questions, intriguingly, Amitoj, about why the police didn't put pressure on the doctors to record the blood and the urine samples. But right now, these are the visuals from Sector 26 police station in Chandigarh. It's raining very heavily, but Vikas Barala and Ashish are inside and we're waiting to report on the further developments.
All right, just explain this to us. They come in and the media is out there trying to get visuals of them. The police barricades the place almost, ensures that they come in through a hush. And we don't really get an understanding of how they entered and how fast this all happened. The police is in a way understanding the situation, the media attention on this story. But at the same time, they're not being very clear on a number of questions that the media is actually asking.
That's absolutely right. And, this started not just today, but the questions that the media asked about the CCTV evidence 2 days ago, the question that the media asked about how long it will take for the police to get their legal opinion on the sections and the technicality of the case, the police has not answered conclusively about how long that will take, and neither have they answered the question that when the two boys refused to give the blood and the urine samples, why didn't the police put pressure on them to take those samples, given that it forms crucial part of the investigation? Right. So a number of questions, Amitoj, that the police also hasn't answered conclusively.
Nikhil, one more thing. You had reflected earlier, this was yesterday, I believe, when you had said that the police is seeking legal guidance in trying to understand whether the charges of kidnapping actually stand in this case and can they actually put those on. Because once they put them on, they can arrest him, bail can be cancelled, etc., which is what is likely to happen today, which is what the buzz is right now, as you explained. But do we have an understanding of what that legal opinion was given to the police, or we don't at this point in time?
Amitoj, they are being very, very tight-lipped about what that legal opinion is. They are not even willing to share how long it will take for that legal opinion to come through. The only crucial things, if we can also recap for our viewers, is that a day after the police lodged the original FIR with charges of stalking and drunken driving, the DSP himself came forward and said that we are mooting to add harsher charges like kidnapping, Section 365, which is a non-bailable offence. He then retracted his statement within under an hour, saying that, based on the girl's statement, the magistrate, that section doesn't stand. Varnika, of course, has denied that claim and said that she is reflected on many levels in the FIR, in her Facebook post, in what she said to the media, that they very clearly intended to kidnap her. So the police also now, after that retraction of their statement, also being forced to take legal counsel within their team. But of course, they've been very, very tight-lipped about what that means. Yesterday, the closest answer we've got to your question, Amitoj, is yesterday, one police source telling NDTV that they are legally deliberating what attempt to abduction would mean and whether an attempt to abduction would amount to a full kidnapping charge.